That's one of those things that you diagram.
Like to see it, but it's very exciting to see. But I would like to just add again or go over again the fact that
Kevin was nearly tackled. He had to fight away from the tackle and push him aside. Not only did the rope open in the background, it opened downfield, and Kevin took two steps to the ball, 45 yards, dead on the money. He couldn't have thrown the ball any better. And he's a senior back, and you expect a lot of things like that from a senior, but just a super football player. I would say that's probably one of the best plays that I have ever seen in high school football. That was just great.
A perfect pass. It was just thrown so well that John Dye at the 7-yard line, when he cradled it in, was the happiest person on the field next to Kevin Soldier. He just went to sleep right now. So it was just a beauty.
I think Tom Dobbin can like to let him part with him.
It's just that play can just, with Kevin Stover in the backfield, Thomas can just come at you so many different ways.
That's right, and it's, you know, it's Kevin that really makes that kind of a play go, because you have to respect him so as a runner. If you don't come up the play, as a runner, goes up about 30 or 40 yards before you get right. And it's just a super, super play. And yeah, it's a shame we don't have this replay to have that. I'll be looking forward to the film on Thursday night just to see that.
Okay, Larry. Flipper Marching Brass entertaining here at halftime, and if you want to see some high school football this weekend, there's plenty of action. Keene at Memorial, Spalding at Salem tomorrow night, back here at Gill, it's Nashua at Trinity. Tomorrow afternoon in Division II, plenty of action. A couple of games on the seacoast. Summersworth is at Exeter, Laconia at Winnicott.
Like this when it rains, so that nobody could run.
I think UNH is winning when it does, but there'll be a lot of people in the stands just because it's homecoming, but I think there'll be a lot more after that excitement in the back.
Well, I would think so. They played a super game up there. They did play a good football game, a total game. They played good defense, good offense, and I know that a lot of people were starting to worry a little bit about UNH football this year, and not the least of which was Bill Lowe, the coach up there, but they get close.
Manchester, the Portsmouth Clippers lead the Manchester Central, Little Green, by a score of 20.
Portsmouth High School Band. Thank you. Thank you.